All right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the round 5 of the Ahrcéus versus Mavi duel. My name is Ahrcéus and I am the GG3 Guild Master. Today, we are at the Suwon International Circuit in South Korea. People, this track is home to a lot of different bumps in the roads, and especially about the uphill straight here. Actually, in a few moments, we'll see it. The uphill straight, as you can see right now, it is the turn where players could go off the track by sudden curbs that could be really hard and could lead to a player zooming off, and that will not be a good way for drivers to hold on to the track. This is the standings we have so far. We have 93 points for Ahrcéus and 80 points for Mavi. Mavi is like 13 points behind, so he has to do his best for this round. We're joined by The Care 2, Peaky Games, and Levita 54 for this race. Alright people, let's get on this video right away.
Okay, radio check, Ahrcéus.
Radio check, loud and clear, Midnight.
Okay, copy that. Just to let you know, there's a bit of rain outside right now. So we're gonna go and run the inters.
Alright, time for inters then. Let's go give this our best, you know what I'm saying? Here we are at the POV of Ahrcéus as we're waiting for the race to begin. Ahrcéus begins in P3 out of 5 because I have just received some word from the officials that the Care 2 has to start from the pit lane because of an unfortunate issue in his car. So today, we're gonna see this action unfold for this race.
I'm sure you already know the dangers of this track. Do not be so overconfident when you go around the uphill. It's gonna be difficult out there.
Oh yes, I hear you, man. I'm actually excited. Let's do this, bro. Ahrcéus is excited indeed, as we're now waiting to see the lights for the Korean Grand Prix. We're about to see action once again in round 5 for the duel. 5 lights, here we are, and now it's time to race in Korea as Ahrcéus gets a decent lead and now approaches Mavi right there in P2. As we can see, the Care goes out of the pit lane and still maintains a P1 right there. Mavi goes a bit too wide, that gives Ahrcéus a chance to be in P2 for this race. And now we have the Care 2 keeping his car on track. Oh my goodness, you have to appreciate his driving right there. He's now building a long gap from him and Ahrcéus into this braking zone. Here we go. Ahrcéus does not catch up to the Care right there. Masterclass!
Man, the Care, bro, he's so far away right now. He just started in the pit lane, right?
Yes, he is about 2 seconds ahead of you. He started in the pit lane, but he's still faster. Insane.
Just imagine that, we're talking about the 3-time world champion, the Care 2, who has won 3 back-to-back seasons for Ion Formula Racing. And now we're approaching the uphill straight. Ahrcéus with a purple sector right there, but I believe the Care still has the actual purple sector, if you know what I mean. Ahrcéus goes under that uphill very nice and steady as they now break down here, and Ahrcéus clips that curb as he approaches towards another braking zone. So people, you have to understand that the Suwon International Circuit isn't just home to several things.
I hear someone coming behind me. Who's that?
I'm afraid that's Mavi, and he's closing on you very, very fast. Be careful.
Oh my goodness, I literally did not know that Mavi was already behind Ahrcéus. But as Midnight and Ahrcéus talked about, as we can see here, Mavi is just behind him. And we'll see if he will be able to overtake Ahrcéus as he goes actually around the outside, the slipstream. Oh no! Mavi gets that slot right there, but he goes back. Ahrcéus gets that overtake nicely.
Good job with the overtake. Now keep it that way.
Yeah, here's a copy loud here.
Your radio.
Oh no! Ahrcéus drifts right there, and I think something just happened. I think a radio problem or something. But as we can see here, Mavi overtakes Ahrcéus. He's now about the car's length ahead of Ahrcéus now. That's quite amazing stuff by Mavi. Oh my goodness.
I just told you to keep it that way. What exactly did you...
Oh, Midnight is so angry right now, people, I gotta tell you. He's so furious that Ahrcéus wasn't able to overtake Mavi right there, and Mavi just had to go away from Ahrcéus right now. Lap 2, and Ahrcéus is already in P3. Oh my goodness. Something must have happened with his radio communications that has to have prevented him from being able to communicate with Midnight in real time. Oh no! Ahrcéus just gets off there and oh, he goes beyond the track onto the grass. That's horrendous.
This is going to happen. Ahrcéus, do you read? Do you read, Ahrcéus?
Copy loud.
Hello? Ahrcéus?
Oh no, this is so bad for Ahrcéus and Aston Martin. No radio communications means they will become slower in this race. No, you gotta understand, Ahrcéus is having a hard time, not just on track, but also trying to communicate with his team. He just sets a yellow sector. Oh my goodness, this radio problem has to be the catalyst for Ahrcéus to just lose this championship. Right now, Mavi is about 3 seconds ahead of Ahrcéus, and Ahrcéus is just struggling to keep his tires on grip. Okay, here he approaches the final straight of lap 3, and Ahrcéus still is in P3. He's not getting the speed that he needs. 2 yellow sectors and only 1 green sectors. That is not doing well for Aston Martin. Oh people, this is quite insane. Ahrcéus has to actually fight so hard to just get behind of Mavi and possibly overtake the McLaren. Oh, by the way, people, as I was saying about McLaren, Mavi has just moved to McLaren for the remaining season, and the Red Bull has just dropped him. I have no idea what happened, but now Mavi is joining the Papaya team. So as you can see here, Mavi is finally part of Team McLaren, and he is enjoying his car right now.
Ahrcéus, if you can hear me, there must be problems with your radio. I need you to press Charlie 420. I repeat, press Charlie 420.
Hey guys, can you hear me now? Can you hear me? You guys hear?
Negative, your radio still choppy. I repeat, your radio still...
Which number?
420, 420, press 420.
Done.
Oh my goodness, Ahrcéus just got so mad, but at least he has his communications back now. I think pressing the 420 button has had the fix needed to get this radio communications work once again. Ahrcéus has now considerably been closing the gap to Mavi. So you can see here, 2 green sectors. Ahrcéus could possibly overtake Mavi right now as he's going to slipstream behind, but oh no! That's dirty air. Oh my goodness, my voice right now, people. That was quite an amazing action we have seen. And Ahrcéus tries to overtake. Oh no!
No! Dang it!
Understood, keep pushing.
Oh no! That has to be so sad for Ahrcéus. That cut slowdown gave him 2 seconds. Oh, that has to be so sad. Ahrcéus was already faster than Mavi for that specific lap. But dang, because of Ahrcéus, you can't really blame him. He's driving on inters, it's wet, and that's just sad, people. But right now, Mavi is now on the lead of Ahrcéus. P2 right now, and Dakar setting fastest lap after fastest lap just shows how much of a true world champion he really is. Mavi right now is in one... I don't even see this right. I don't even read the numbers, but you can see here, he's ahead of Ahrcéus.
I understand you might be a little bit mad. But now we're giving you permission to use Tactic 69. Full send.
No, I'm sorry guys. I'm sorry for shouting at you earlier. But okay.
Last lap, Ahrcéus. Go for it, my friend.
Okay, this is so sweet between these two drivers. The last lap is finally unfolding, and Ahrcéus is given chance to use Tactic 69. As we've seen here, Mavi goes beyond the track. Ahrcéus with more power given to him. As you can see, his ERS levels are quite okay, but I don't think that will be enough to possibly overtake Mavi as much as he could. Ahrcéus gets a yellow sector one. Might be another yellow sector as well. We may never know, but they're now closing in on the final parts of this race. Okay, Ahrcéus tries to overtake. Oh no, that's so sad. He tried to go inside, but then the rear tire just got off. Okay, on to the final corners, the final turns of this race, and the Dakar 2 wins already the Korean Grand Prix. Ahrcéus gets so close to Mavi. Mavi's just right there. Oh my goodness, will Mavi win? And he does. Oh wow.
No, that was good. Man, good job. That was so close, bro. Dang!
That was a good recovery, my friend. The radio problem caused you to have problems in the race, but you drove well today.
Yeah, we gotta go fix the radio, but good game to Mavi, Dakar, and to everyone else.
Oh my goodness, people, that race just got my voice out of my lungs already, if that even makes sense. Ahrcéus sadly does not take home the victory. That means Mavi goes up in the standings. We'll see the standings later on, but as you can see here, the race replay, my goodness, the overtake that Mavi had in just lap 2 was the catalyst for him to eventually win this race, and that was so great. Ahrcéus is now in 111 points, Mavi in 105 points, my goodness, 6 points separates these two drivers. As we can see here, the lineup, the results, the care 2 first place, Ahrcéus in P3, Mavi in P2, Levita in P4, and Peaky Games in P5. Oh wow, this race has been so awesome indeed, GG3, and we can't wait for round 6. That's gonna be in Australia. Last time we've been there, we've had a lot of action, but we're gonna save that sometime for next week or this week, we may never know. If you have enjoyed this video, I'd really appreciate it if you could please like and subscribe to join the GG3 today. Please also join my Discord server. We're trying to get to 300 members today, so please do that. Thank you so much everyone for joining me in this video, and I'll see you soon, so stay tuned for more videos on this channel. Always remember, the winner lose good game, and GG3 for life.
Destination or the journey you're finding. When you top that hill, there's still a mountain behind it. All the time the stage around you's changing. So isn't it your business not to just maintain, but change within it? No limits but the ones you place upon yourself. These trophies on your shelf made